Let's get an update on the weather now from PAGASA weather forecaster Rhea Torres. Rhea, good morning.
Yes, good morning to you as well, Rica. As of the moment, the southwest monsoon continues to affect the western sections of northern and central Luzon. Although currently the southwest monsoon is weakened, therefore for Metro Manila and the rest of the country, generally fair weather conditions may be expected. Although there are still chances of isolated rain showers or thunderstorms, usually by the evening due to localized thunderstorms. We currently have no gale warning raised over the seaboards of our country. Therefore, for our fisher folks and those with small sea crafts, they are free to venture out into the sea. And since we are currently not monitoring any low-pressure area or tropical cyclone within and outside our Philippine area of responsibility, over the next following days, over large portions of our country, the general fair weather conditions may still persist. Temperatures over Metro Manila will be ranging from 26 to 34 degrees Celsius, 16 to 24 degrees for Baguio City, 26 to 33 degrees Celsius for Legazpi, Metro Cebu 26 to 32, and for Metro Davao 25 to 33 degrees Celsius. And that is the latest here from PAGASA Weather Forecasting Center. This is Rhea Torres reporting.
Thank you so much, Rhea. Good morning. President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. calls on ASEAN to oppose the dangerous use of Coast Guard and militia vessels in the South China Sea. Marcos made that remark before world leaders during the ASEAN East Asia Summit Thursday. The Philippine leader, again, did not directly name any country, but China's Coast Guard recently launched a water cannon attack and a blockade to stop Philippine vessels from delivering supplies to Manila's outpost in the Iyumiyan Shoal.
The Philippines fully supports adherence to international law and the rules-based order. We must oppose the dangerous use of Coast Guard and maritime militia vessels in the South China Sea. We are concerned over illegal, unreported, and unregulated fishing and the militarization of reclaimed features in the South China Sea. The Philippines remains resolute towards the peaceful resolution of disputes. We continue to support freedom of navigation and overflight and the rules-based international order in the South China Sea.
The Philippines has received the support of its regional peers when it comes to maritime issues. Indonesian President and outgoing ASEAN Chairman Joko Widodo also urged other countries to exercise self-restraint in the conduct of activities that may complicate or escalate disputes in the South China Sea.
This is where the international community will assess if we are leaders with the wisdom to make the world a better place for all. I ask once again to the leaders of East Asia Summit to make this forum for us to strengthen cooperation, not sharpening rivalries.
The Philippines and South Korea ink a free trade agreement on the sidelines of the 43rd ASEAN Summit in Indonesia. The FTA, which was being negotiated long before the pandemic, is expected to cut tariffs for select products to zero to boost trade between the two countries.
The FTA will strengthen our bilateral trade and investment relations with the Republic of Korea, especially as it generates jobs and contributes to the Philippines' value proposition as an ideal regional hub for smart and sustainable investments. The signing of the FTA is a testament to the realization of the many opportunities for complementation and collaboration between the Philippines and South Korea, and an even greater milestone for our economic friendship.
Bilateral trade between the Philippines and South Korea amounted to $15.44 billion in 2022 alone. This makes South Korea the fourth largest trading partner of the Philippines. Among the Philippines' top exports to South Korea are integrated circuits, semiconductors, and bananas. The Philippines also made progress in some agriculture deals with other countries, during the regional meet in Indonesia. Katrina Domingo has more on this.
The Philippines and Vietnam are expected to work on a five-year rice trading agreement. That's what Vietnamese Prime Minister Pham Minh Chinh announced during his bilateral meeting with President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. on the sidelines of the ASEAN Summit in Jakarta.
Our two countries will conclude an intergovernment agreement on rice trade so that Vietnam can ensure rice export to the Philippines and ensure ensure the food security of the people. So we look forward to having a stable framework of cooperation on rice trade for a long period of at least 5 years. And with that, we can ensure our production, and you can also ensure the import.
Marcos Jr. calls the possible deal important as food security is among the main issues in the Philippines. Last week, Malacañang placed a price ceiling on regular milled and well-milled rice as the government probes traders who are allegedly hoarding sacks of rice to manipulate market prices of the staple grain. Data from Malacañang showed that in the first 5 months of 2023, the Philippines shelled out some $772.4 million to import 1.5 million tons of rice from Vietnam. The volume is 42.3% or nearly half of Vietnam's rice exports from January to May this year. Aside from agriculture, the Philippines and Vietnam also tackled possible cooperation agreements in the South China Sea and in digital economy. Meantime, in his bilateral meeting with Cambodian Prime Minister Hun Manet, President Marcos also floated the idea of potential deals in agriculture and information technology.
In the Philippines, we have put the front and center as a priority in our economic planning and transformation, agriculture. Especially with the, in the face of what we are of we are anticipating in terms of the El Nino and all of, and the drought that it brings, we hope that we can find an agreement.
The Filipino leader also vowed to review the prospect of opening more routes and flights between the Philippines and Cambodia. Katrina Domingo, ABS-CBN News, Jakarta, Indonesia.
Over now to the resignation of Finance Undersecretary Cheryl Magno. Malacañang says it terminated the appointment of Magno for being unsupportive of the Marcos administration. In a statement, the Office of Executive Secretary Lucas Bersamian also said Magno has been against the administration's policies. He added the termination of Magno's appointment should have been expected. Magno announced her resignation Thursday. She led discussions on reforming the military and uniform personnel pension system and had pushed for higher tax on mining. Before quitting her post, Magno posted a cryptic photo showing a chart of the law of supply and demand. Magno's resignation will take effect on September 16. Philippine rice retailers say government subsidies are not enough to cover their losses due to the rice price cap. Rice retailers on Thursday held an emergency meeting to tackle the worsening effects of the price ceiling on their businesses. Based on a computation of the Grains Retailers Group, an average retailer selling 20 sacks of rice daily is set to lose 49,000 pesos worth of profit due to rice price caps.
Hindi natin talaga kakayanin yung 15,000. So yun naman is nakikita rin natin kung ganun yung puntulong, makakabawas na rin sa gastusin. Kaya alam po talaga, hindi aabot lalo na sa mga retailers talaga natin maliliit.
The Agriculture Department, however, stressed majority of retailers are following the policy. It adds, government will continue to monitor the effects of the price ceiling.
So far, nakita naman natin na 90%+ compliance or at least partial compliance rate ang nakita natin. The government, particularly NEDA and DTI, are really studying this, the effects of the price ceiling. So talagang tulong-tulong po ang maraming government agencies at talagang pinag-aralan naman po ito ng ating gobyerno.
The Philippine Defense Department is seeking a 12% increase for its 2024 budget. But it denies that the United States has a say in its budget planning after the country's bilateral defense guidelines with the U.S. was questioned by some lawmakers. Vivian Gulia reports.
Undersecretary Pablo.
The United States has no involvement in the crafting of the proposed 2024 budget for the Philippine Department of National Defense. Defense Secretary Gilberto Teodoro Jr. issued this assurance during the House Committee on Appropriations deliberation on DND's proposed 229.9 billion peso budget for next year. Under the U.S.-Philippines bilateral defense guidelines, which was established last May by U.S. Secretary of Defense Lloyd Austin III and then-acting Defense Secretary Carlito Galvez Jr., the two countries agreed to coordinate closely on the Philippines' defense budget planning, including through the development of a security sector assistance roadmap to identify priority defense platforms and force packages over the next 5 years. Teodoro said he will review these guidelines.
Mismo yung bilateral security guidelines shows na sila pwedeng makialam sa atin pero tayo hindi naman natin yun magagawa. No? So it's not even bilateral or fair. Are we saying na merong mali doon sa bilateral security guidelines?
Re-reviewin po namin yung bilateral security guidelines kasi wala pong coordination na nangyayari.
The defense chief defended the allocation of funds for military sites in the country, which are covered by the Enhanced Defense Cooperation Agreement with the U.S. Teodoro says it is necessary in order for the Philippines to maintain its independence, but the country will get capability assistance from the U.S. once it hurdles security assessments. He stressed the importance of the Philippines' alliance with the United States and other countries in asserting rules-based international order in parts of the West Philippine Sea against China's claims. Teodoro said China's 10-dash line map is an evidence of its expansionist agenda, adding that while the Philippines is taking the diplomatic route in asserting its rights over the West Philippine Sea, it should also continue to upgrade defense capabilities.
O bakit po natin hinahayaan yung US na para ba ang footing na ay magkaroon na ng digmaan sa West Philippine Sea?
Hindi po ganun ang aking pananaw. Sino ba ho nagwo-water cannon? US ba po o China? Sino ang nasa war footing? Tayo ho ba o sila? Sa akin po malayo po at ayoko pong magkagera. Ngunit ang diplomasya po pag hindi natin binakapan ng katatagan sa paraan ng pagkakaroon nang matibay na kapabilidad na tayuan ng iyong sarili, baliwala ho ang democracy, lalo na sa determinadong malaking bansa na may hangarin na kupkupin ang buong South China Sea. We will not back down. We will continue to be doing what we are doing. And we will continue to build up alliances with like-minded nations in order to enforce international law.
Amid such threats, funding deficiency for the revised Armed Forces of the Philippines Modernization Program is at 328.57 billion pesos. Only 50 billion pesos was allocated for it next year.
Gaps in our command and control, gaps in our ability to deter and to detect incursions into the West Philippine Sea and our overall defense posture. It is best right now to review and revision what we really need based on the threat situations that we see and the transition of our AFP from internal security to territorial defense, which will include an internal security dimension.
Part of AFP's proposed 2024 budget is a 75 million peso allocation for the Vice Presidential Security and Protection Group. It currently has 345 personnel, according to Teodoro. A report from the Commission on Audit showed that security detail for the VP increased more than fourfold to 433 personnel in the second half of last year when Sara Duterte assumed the post.
Tatayuan ko po ang necessity ng BPS-PG kasi ang Vice Presidente po nung araw ay dinadagdag yan sa PSG budget at hindi po consistent ang kanilang suporta. Kaya minabuti po ng nauna sa akin si Secretary Lorenzana na gumawa ng BPSPG. Kaya 400 po yan dahil OBP, mga advanced locations po na pinupuntahan niya, DepEd, rotation po ng mga staff at support po sa kanyang opisina. Pagka hindi ho nilitaw ito ng tama, mabuti nga po nilitaw, kukunin ho ito sa iba't ibang mga units sa mga requirements niya.
The House panel terminated on Thursday its deliberations on DND's proposed 2024 budget. It will next be tackled at the plenary. Vivian Gulia, ABS-CBN News.